This section will introduce you to onboard emergencies and how to handle various emergency situations such as man overboard, medical evacuation, fire, groundings, hull damage, etc. Persons in command should not delay notifying the search and rescue system if a problem is or may be developing, which could involve a need for assistance. This allows the search and rescue system to carry out preliminary and contingency planning that could make the critical difference if the situation worsens. The spoken emergency signals are used by aircraft and vessels. We can divide these signals into the following groups: distress signal, urgency signal, safety signal. Any message headed by one of these signals has precedence over routine messages. Three spoken emergency signals are used by aircraft and vessels. The distress signal Mayday is used to indicate that a mobile craft is in imminent danger and requests immediate assistance. The urgency signal Pan-Pan is used when the safety of a mobile craft is in jeopardy. The urgency signal Pan-Pan should be used when an unsafe situation exists that may eventually involve a need for assistance. The safety signal Security is used for messages concerning safety of navigation or giving important meteorological warnings. The following procedural words should be fully understood by all search and rescue personnel. Affirmative means that what a person has transmitted is correct. Break is used to separate portions of a message or one message from another. Figures is spoken just before numbers are given in a message. I spell is used just before a phonetic spelling, such as a proper name. Negative means no. Out indicates the end of a transmission, when no reply is expected or required. Over indicates the end of a transmission, when an immediate reply is expected. Roger means, I have received your transmission satisfactorily. Silence is said three times and means, cease all transmissions immediately. Silence fini, pronounced silence fini, means, silence is lifted, and is used to signify the end of the emergency and resumption of normal traffic. This is said before the station name or call sign which immediately follows. Wait means, I must pause for a few seconds. Stand by for further transmission. Use of one or more of the following international maritime distress frequencies to transmit a distress alert. GMDSS 2182 kHz radio telephony. VHF channel 16. In the event of failure of the ship's radio station, it may be possible to transmit a message using portable equipment, provided for use in survival craft. An aircraft in distress may use any means at its disposal to attract attention, make known its position, and obtain help. The aircraft would normally notify an ATS unit, which should notify the coordination center. Use emergency frequency 121.5 MHz if there is no response on the assigned en route frequency, and transmit blind. Squawk transponder emergency code 7700 for distress. The emergency position indicating radio beacon and emergency locator transmitter are another means of alerting. They are intended for alerting when other available means of alerting are inadequate. An EPIRB transmits a signal that alerts search and rescue authorities and allows rescue facilities to home in on the distressed vessel. Most civil aircraft carry ELT to alert search and rescue authorities to a distressed situation. SOLAS ship requirements include the following: two-way VHF radio telephone apparatus and survival craft radar transponders to be placed on each side of the vessel, in a position to be taken on board a survival craft. Important components of the distress message should include identification of the vessel, position, nature of distress and kind of assistance required, weather in immediate vicinity, time of abandoning ship, number of crew remaining on board, number and type of survival craft launched, emergency location aids in survival craft or in the sea, number of seriously injured. Cancellation should occur as soon as the distressed craft has been recovered, or when the assistance of search and rescue facilities is no longer required. Any false alert, including by inadvertent human error, should be cancelled so that search and rescue authorities do not needlessly respond. Medico messages are requests for medical advice or assistance from and to a vessel at sea. Medico messages should be prefixed DH Medico, so the communication personnel know how to handle them as medico messages. Search and rescue services may provide medical advice either with their own doctors or via arrangements with doctors outside the search and rescue organization. A number of commercial and government radio stations provide a free medical message service to ships. If medical evacuations are being considered, the benefits must be weighed against the inherent dangers of such operations to both the person needing assistance and to the rescue personnel. The final decision about whether it is safe to conduct an evacuation remains ultimately with the person in command of the rescue facility tasked with conducting the evacuation. A person overboard situation can be grouped into three different scenarios: immediate action, delayed action, person missing action. When the possibility exists that a person has fallen overboard, the crew must attempt to recover the individual as soon as possible. The person overboard is noticed from the bridge and action is taken immediately. The initial action should be: throw a life buoy over the side as close to the person as possible. Sound three prolonged blasts of the ship's whistle. Hail, person overboard. Note the position, wind speed, wind direction, and time. Inform the master and engine room. Post lookouts to keep the person in sight. Set off a dye marker or smoke flare. Inform the radio operator and keep updated on the position. Stand by the engines. Prepare a lifeboat for possible launching. Distribute portable VHF radios for communication between the bridge, deck and lifeboat. Rig the pilot ladder to assist in recovery. There are several standard manoeuvres, each with its advantages and disadvantages depending on the ship type, speed, weather conditions, etc. The Williamson turn is probably one of the best known. Here are some parameters to remember about the Williamson turn. It makes good the original track line. Good in reduced visibility. Simple. It takes the ship further away from the scene of the incident. Slow procedure. The Williamson turn is executed by putting the rudder hard over. After deviation from the original course by 60 degrees, put the rudder hard over to the opposite side. When the heading is 20 degrees short of the opposite course, put the rudder to amidships position and steady on opposite course. Here are some parameters to remember about the one turn. Fastest recovery method. Good for ships with tight turning characteristics. Used mostly by ships with considerable power. Very difficult for a single screw vessel. Difficult because approached person is not straight. The one turn is executed by putting the rudder hard over. After deviation from the original course by 250 degrees, rudder to amidships position and stopping manoeuvring to be initiated. Scharnov turn parameters to be remembered are: will take vessel back into her wake. Less distance is covered, saving time. Cannot be carried out effectively unless the time elapsed between occurrence of the incident and the commencement of the manoeuvre is known. The Scharnov turn is executed by putting the rudder hard over. After deviation from the original course by 240 degrees, rudder hard over to the opposite side. When the heading is 20 degrees short of opposite course, rudder to midship position so that ship will turn to opposite course. Here are some points to remember in case of a fire on board. Activate the fire alarm. Report the location of fire. Assess fire. Determine the class of fire. Determine appropriate extinguishing equipment. Determine the appropriate method of attack. Determine how to prevent the spread of the fire. Determine the required personnel and firefighting assignments. Establish proper communications between the bridge and the location of fire. Begin procedures for attacking the fire. Continue until the fire is extinguished. If assistance is required, transmit a distress call and message. Here are some points to remember in case of grounding. Check for hull damage. If assistance is required, transmit a PAN-PAN urgency signal. Determine which way deep water lies. Determine if wind and sea are carrying the vessel harder aground. Lessen the draft of the vessel. Put engines astern to back away. If extrication is impossible until assistance arrives or change of tide, minimize hull damage and water intake. In case of hull damage, the following points should be remembered. Identify the location of incoming water. Cut off all electrical power running through the area. Shore up the area to stem water flow. Check bilge pump for operation. Check auxiliary pumps for backup operation if needed. If necessary, abandon the vessel as a last resort. Remember the following when abandoning the ship. Abandon ship only as a last resort. Transmit a distress call and message. Wear life jackets and adequate clothing. In waters below 16 Celsius, put on immersion suits. Have crew members stand by lifeboat or life raft and prepare to launch. Make sure sea painter is attached to vessel. Load crew and launch. Keep life raft tethered to vessel as long as possible. In case of a medical emergency, the following points should be remembered. Conduct an assessment of the victim for primary medical treatment. Attend to treatment as best as possible with onboard facilities and medications. If medical evacuation is required, alert the proper authorities. Prepare the patient for evacuation. Gather appropriate paperwork and attach to the patient. Attacks on merchant ships by pirates and armed robbers are an increasing problem in today's shipping, and not, as many people believe, an action from the past. The following points should be taken into account in case of piracy. Comply with orders from the pirates. If possible, try to activate the Inmarsat C special message provided for use when attacked by pirates. Leave the pirates unaware that a message has been transmitted. When the coordination center becomes aware of a piracy situation, it will advise appropriate agencies.